Hello, let us see RCC water tanks. This is lecture number 7 and here I am going to talk about the theory of circular water tanks with rigid base, that is fixed base, resting on the ground by working stress method. Now in last lecture, that is lecture number 6, we have talked about circular water tanks with flexible base resting on ground. Here it is a rigid base. So this is a schematic view of water tank resting on base with rigid base. So this is a circular wall and this is the base slab, and here rigid base means the joint between wall and slab, that is these joints, it is rigid or it is fixed, it is not flexible, and therefore the elastic curve or the deflected shape because of the internal water pressure will look like this. Whereas had the base been flexible or sliding joint, then the deflection wouldn't have been like this, then it would have deflected in this manner. That means because of the flexible base, the base would have been allowed to deflect outwards, and therefore the deflected shape would have been something like triangular, like this. But here, since the base is made rigid, that means the joint between wall and the base slab is fixed, and therefore the deflected shape or the elastic curve of the wall looks like this, whatever shown by blue dotted lines, and therefore this wall is capable of resisting the pressure by developing bending moment as well as by developing the hoop tension or circular or circumferential tension. Whereas in flexible base, the internal water pressure was resisted by hoop tension or circumferential tension alone, because since there was no rigid base, there was no question of bending moment getting developed. Now let us move further. If the wall of circular tank is fixed, that is rigid with base, the wall is subjected to horizontal shear, that is shear force, in addition to the hoop or circular circumferential tension. If the tank is tall with small diameter, then it resists the internal liquid pressure primarily by ring or hoop tension and to a lesser extent by horizontal shear at base. Whereas if the tank is shallow and the diameter is large, then it resists the internal liquid pressure primarily by cantilever action from the base and to a lesser degree by hoop tension. The cantilever action means we know that the base is fixed or rigid, and therefore the bottom part of the water tank, it acts like a cantilever. Because of the triangular pressure from inside, it will bend like a cantilever. If the tank is having both height and diameter as medium dimensions, that means neither it is too tall, too short, nor the diameter is too large or too small, then the tank resists the loads by both hoop tension as well as cantilever action. Now, moving further, consider a circular water tank with rigid base. So here it is a circular water tank with rigid base. That means here the connection between wall and base slab is rigid. T is the thickness of the wall, D is the internal diameter, and this is the pressure distribution diagram. Let PC is pressure per unit area transferred by cantilever action. C stands for cantilever action. So PC is the pressure of water per unit area which is transferred because of the cantilever action, whereas PR is a pressure per unit area transferred by hoop tension. R stands for radial because it is in the circumferential direction. Let I is equal to moment of inertia per unit length of this cross section, and it is given by thickness cube divided by 12 into 1 minus mu square, where mu is the Poisson's ratio. Let YR is equal to radial expansion due to PR. So it's very simple to understand. That is PR, that is the pressure due to hoop tension causes the expansion in the radial direction. YC is the outward deflection due to cantilever action. That means due to PC, that is the pressure due to cantilever action causes the outward deflection YC. Moving further, at any height x from the base, PC plus PR equal to gamma W H minus X. This is very simple to understand. Now we will consider any point, this point, at a distance x from the base, and therefore the distance of this point from the top is H minus X because the total height is H, and therefore from fluid mechanics theory, the pressure at this point is unit weight of water into the height from the top, that is gamma W into H minus X. So that is what I have written here. Now LHS, why it is PC plus PR? Because the pressure caused at this point at a distance x from the base is because of PC plus PR, that is pressure due to cantilever action, that is due to bending moment effect, as well as the pressure due to the radial action or the hoop tension, circumferential tension, and therefore PC plus PR is equal to gamma W H minus X. So this left side talks about the internal pressure created by water, whereas right side talks about the equation due to the concepts of fluid mechanics. Now hoop tension at height x from the base T is equal to the radial pressure into internal diameter divided by 2. This formula we have seen in the last lecture, that is lecture number 6, and therefore hoop stress equal to PRD upon 2T, and therefore hoop strain is nothing but hoop stress by Young's modulus. We know that strain is stress by Young's modulus, therefore hoop strain is hoop stress by Young's modulus. It becomes PRD upon 2TE. Therefore hoop strain at distance x from base is radial expansion yr due to PR divided by radius r. We know the general definition of strain, that it is change in something divided by original that thing. So here we want the hoop strain or the radial strain, or you can say diametral strain, at a distance x from the base. Therefore it is nothing but the change or the expansion yr due to PR divided by the original radius, that is r. And therefore by cross multiplying we get yr is equal to hoop strain into the radius, and therefore already we know that hoop strain is PRD upon 2TE and radius is diameter by 2. When we simplify, yr, that is expansion due to PR, is equal to PRD square upon 4TE. So we can say that PR is 4T YR upon D square. Let it be equation number 1. However, very importantly, for compatibility, YC is equal to YR must be equal to Y. That means at any point in the wall, whether it is the outward deflection due to cantilever action or whether it is the expansion due to the pressure PR, the deflection must be same, and therefore instead of writing it as YC or YR, because of compatibility it can be indicated by a common entity Y, and therefore equation 1 becomes PR equal to 4TEY upon D square. Here instead of YR I have substituted Y. Let it be equation 2. Moving further, the load intensity, that is pressure per unit area transferred by cantilever action at the bottom, is given by PC is equal to EI D4YC upon DX4, equation 3. Here we have learnt in strength of materials that load intensity is EI, that is flexural rigidity, into D4 y upon dx4. Here y is nothing but yc, because here we want to calculate load intensity pc, and therefore it is yc here. Also we have seen that pc plus pr is equal to gamma wh minus x, and therefore pc becomes gamma wh minus x minus pr, that is taking pr on this side it becomes minus. Moving further, since in equation 3 also it is pc lhs, whereas equation 4 also lhs it is pc, so we will equate equation 3 and 4, and therefore it becomes ei d4 yc upon dx4 equal to gamma wh minus x minus pr. Let it be equation 5. Now we know that by compatibility we can say yc equal to y. Again we know that pr equal to 4 tey upon d square from equation 1. Again we know moment of inertia is t cube upon 12 1 minus mu square. All this we can substitute in equation 5, and therefore it becomes et cube upon 12 1 minus mu square into d4y upon dx4 is equal to gamma wh minus x minus 4 ty upon d square. Let it be equation number 6. We can rearrange the above equation and it results into a very important equation, that is equation number 7, d4y upon dx4 plus 48 1 minus mu square y upon d square t square, that is equal to 12 gamma w 1 minus mu square h minus x divided by et cube. Now the solution to this differential equation can be written as y is equal to e raised to kx, a cos kx plus b sin kx plus e raised to minus kx c cos kx plus d sin kx plus gamma w h minus x d square upon 4 et, where k is 12 1 minus mu square upon d square t square whole raised to 1 by 4. The constants a, b, c and d depend on restraint provided at the top and bottom of the tank. The circular wall, or the circular tank wall rather, is fixed at the base, whereas it is free at the top. Therefore at top shear force is 0 as well as bending moment is 0, because it is free at the top. Whereas at the bottom, since it is fixed or it is a rigid support, and therefore slope is also 0 and deflection is also 0. Therefore we can say at bottom, where x is equal to 0, deflection is equal to 0, and therefore we can say EIY is equal to 0. We know from strength of materials that y we use for deflection. EI is the flexure rigidity, and therefore at the bottom where x equal to 0, EI y is equal to 0. Again at the bottom x equal to 0, we know that slope is also 0, and therefore EI dy by dx is 0. Dy by dx is nothing but the slope. At top where x equal to h, shear force is 0 since it is a free end, and therefore EI d cube y upon dx cube is equal to 0, because shear force is given by EI d cube y upon dx cube. At top x equal to h, bending moment is equal to 0 again since it is a free end, and therefore EI d square upon dx square is equal to 0. So all these four terms we have learnt in strength of materials at second year. So here EI d square upon dx square is called as differential equation of flexure, where EI is the flexural rigidity. Now from the above four equations, solution of that elastic curve is known. Therefore PC and PR, that is pressure because of cantilevering action and pressure because of the hoop tension or the radial action, can be found at different heights of the water tank. Now here if we refer IS 3370 part 4, table number 9 talks about tension in circular ring wall fixed at the base and free at the top and subjected to triangular load. So here we can see that it is a water tank whose internal diameter is d, thickness of the wall is t, height is h, and it is subjected to triangular water pressure, and the tension, hoop tension, is given as this coefficient which are given in this table, into WHR. Here W is nothing but gamma W, that is unit weight of water, H is the height, and R is the radius, that is D by 2. So we can say that instead of W, I will say gamma W, so it is gamma W H D by 2. So how these coefficients are given in this table, let us see in brief. Now what they do is, this one, column number 1, they take H square by DT, where H is the height of the water tank, D is the internal diameter, and T is the thickness. So there are various values for H square by DT, and then here row wise we can see that it is 0H up to 0.9H. So these are the various coefficients to be multiplied to this gamma W HD by 2 to obtain the hoop tension at a particular height. Now 0H means it is at the bottom, 0.1H, that means 0.1 times into H from the bottom. For example, if H is 5000 mm, that is 5 meter, then 0.1H is 0.1 into 5000, that is 500 mm, or half meter from the bottom. There the coefficient for the hoop tension is plus 0.134, like that 0.2H, 0.3H up to 0.9H, and therefore we can see it very easily that the coefficients for hoop tension are reducing from the bottom to the top. And that is obvious also, because as we go towards top, the pressure of the water is reducing, and therefore hoop tension also gradually reduces. Now here note 1, gamma W is the density of the liquid. Here, since we are learning water tank, it is a density of water tank, the water. And note 2, the positive sign indicates the tension. Next, again table number 10 in the same IS code, they give the coefficient for moments in cylindrical wall, fixed at base and free at top, and subjected to triangular load. Again here the moment is coefficient into gamma W H cube. Now some people may wonder why it is H cube. What they have done here, that actually if we take bending moment at the base, then actually how we shall take bending moment? Now the area of this triangular diagram is half base into height, so it is half base is gamma W into H and height is H, so it is gamma W H square by 2. And when we take bending moment at the base, that gamma W H square by 2 will act at 1/3 from the base, so it becomes gamma W H cube by 6. But then what they have done is they have only taken gamma W H cube, and whatever that 1 by 6, they have included that in the coefficient, so it is all inclusive of that. So it is half gamma W into H, that is gamma W H square by 2, into H by 3, that is gamma W H cube by 6. So that 1 by 6, it is inbuilt in this coefficient, and therefore it is coefficient into gamma W H cube. Now again, in the same manner here, it is given for various H square by DT, and for various H, they have given the coefficients. Again here, gamma W is the density of the liquid, and positive sign indicates tension on the outer side. And finally, table number 11 gives shear at the base for cylindrical wall. So again here, these are the coefficients for the shear force. Again here, first column talks about H square by DT, and here second column is triangular load at fixed base. So here again, the positive sign indicates that shear is acting inwards. Thank you very much.